Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of Laravel on a Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World Laravel project on our Windows operating system. So to watch the video till the end, I can guarantee you this video is going to be really interesting. So if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always comment me on our comment sections, and I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also ask me with all of your doubts with screenshots and everything over there. I'll definitely going to help you. So now to install a Laravel and create a Laravel project, you will need basically three things. First is PHP, and the next thing is a composer, and the third is a text editor. So we'll be using Visual Studio Code, and for PHP we'll be using WAMP, and we'll use composer. So first simply go to your favorite browser and just simply type composer, download, hit enter. So that will show you this getcomposer.org. So just simply click on this download button and immediately we'll see, you know, this composer.exe setup over here. So this link I'm going to provide right in our description. So once you are here, you're going to click on this composer setup.exe. And you will see that our composer is slightly started downloading, and it is rightly downloaded over here, composer setup. Alright, so next thing that you will need is Visual Studio Code. Just simply type Visual Studio Code and just click on download, and this link also I'm going to provide right in your description. So just simply click on this download and you will have Visual Studio Code as well downloaded over here, right? And the third thing that you will need is WAMP server. So again, I have made a detailed video about WAMP server. So using WAMP server, we'll use that PHP. So again, I have made a dedicated video about WAMP server. I don't want to, you know, remake that same video over again. You can just follow that video, or if you are having any other PHP, you know, installed, so you can use that also. I'll be showing that step right in this video itself. All right. So you need to have WAMP server or any PHP, you know, you need to have on your system, and you need to have composer, and you need to finally have one text editor, and for that I'll be using Visual Studio Code. All right, so that's all. Just minimize this and go to your download directory. So you can see our composer and Visual Studio Code is rightly over here. Let's install one by one. Let's start with Visual Studio Code. Accept the license agreement, click on next, Visual Studio Code is going to create a folder, click on next, accept all the checkboxes, click on next, install. So preparing to install, and it's going to start installing our Visual Studio Code. And it has rightly installed. So you know, you can just simply click on finish, and it's going to launch Visual Studio Code. You can close this for the time being. Right, next you need to install composer. So remember, I have told you need to install PHP. So you need to install WAMP server or XAMPP or normal PHP, whichever you like. The main thing is on your, you know, C drive. If you go to C drive, you can use XAMPP also. So if you go inside WAMP 64, you'll see there is a bin folder. Go inside that bin folder, you'll see a PHP folder. So go inside that PHP folder and you'll see all these different PHP versions are available, right? So we'll be using a latest version. So this folder is what we need to point on composer. If you are using XAMPP, then also you can go to XAMPP folder and see a PHP folder. Go inside that PHP folder, and this is what you need to point to composer, right? So let's go to our download directory and install our composer. So click on install, click on yes, and it will show you this installation options. Click on next. So here, if you see, it is showing all these different paths, right? So I have showed you that XAMPP folder path also, WAMP folder path also, all these different PHPs are available. So it is asking me to select one of them. If you are using XAMPP, you need to select XAMPP, or if you're using WAMP, you can select WAMP, whichever you like, right? Basically that php.exe path is what you need to point it over here. I'll select the latest, you know, PHP, that is 8.3.6 under WAMP 64 folder. I'll select that. I'll also check this, add this path to your environment path, basically. Just click on next after that, and it's going to, you know, start installing our composer. So for this you can keep it default and click on next. So it's ready to be installed. Click on install, and there you go. You can see that it is rightly installed. So just simply click on next, and let's click on finish. So our composer is rightly installed. If you go to search and type cmd to open our command prompt, and within command prompt if you just simply type composer and hit enter, you'll see this prompt coming from composer. So our latest version of composer at the time of making of this video, version 2.7.9, is successfully installed on our system. Right, so in this way you can easily install composer. I have also showed you how to install Visual Studio Code. Next thing is how to create a Laravel project. So let's, you know, close this all. Let's create a new folder first. Let's give the folder name as Laravel-workspace. Go inside that folder, and let's open this folder on cmd. So all of my Laravel projects will stay under Laravel-workspace main directory, and in number of projects that I'll be creating will be inside this project. So now how to create a Laravel project. So let's again go to your browser. Let's see Laravel documentation. So just type Laravel and hit enter. So just go to laravel.com and let's go to documentation. So here we have this installation guide. Scroll down and you will see we have a script over here. So composer, create a project Laravel. So Laravel, then our project name, which is example app. Just, you know, click on this icon to copy this thing, this script, and go inside this Laravel workspace folder that we have created, and right click and, you know, paste that thing and click on enter. So it's going to immediately start creating your Laravel projects. So you can see it is rightly started downloading and it is installing, right? So it is downloading our Laravel and then it is creating our Laravel projects. So you need to have active internet connection right throughout this installation. It's going to fetch all the files from internet and then going to install it. You can see it is rightly started doing that. So it will take about a couple of minutes. So by the time it gets installed, I'll request you do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel as well. Here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos. I'll be highly motivated if you subscribe this channel along with Geeky Script blogging channel. And let's wait for a couple of minutes over here. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our Laravel project is actually created. So everything is done now properly. So what you can do is you can just simply, if you see here we have created this example app, so that is rightly created. So let's go inside this app. So just simply type cd then example dash app, hit enter, and we are inside this example app now. So you can type code space dot and hit enter. So that's going to trigger Visual Studio Code and will open this example app within Visual Studio Code. You can click on this I trust the authors and all, and you can maximize this. So our example app is rightly open within Visual Studio Code, and you can see your project structure over here. You can always expand this app. You will see HTTP folder over here. You can expand this. You'll see controller.php over here. We'll have model user.php. You can also expand these resources. You will see view over here. So this is our main HTML script, so that will get rendered on our browser. So let's run our app. So go to terminal and click on new terminal, and just simply type over here php space artisans serve and hit enter. So what it's going to do is it's going to start our server on this URL. So you need to just click on control and then it click on this link, and immediately it's going to you know, redirect to browser this localhost URL with 8000 port, and our project is up and running over here, right? So you can see it is, you know, running properly. So you go to your Visual Studio Code, and here is our welcome.blade.php file. So this body tag, let's say, you know, you remove whatever there it's inside this body tag. So you remove the stuff, and let's keep only something like p tag, and within p tag let's print something like hello world, and with, you know, p tag, click on save, and go to your browser now. You can refresh and you can see everything is wiped out and it is only showing the output hello world. So whatever you have written, so that same thing will only show, only going to show on our browser, right? So in this way you can easily install Laravel, you can create a Laravel project, and you can start working on your Laravel assignments that probably want to work. So that's basically all about this video. Please do consider subscribing to our Geeky Syntax channel and our Geeky Script blogging channel. I am making a lot of coding related videos. You can always watch my other videos as well. I have also made a video about WordPress. So complete dedicated video, 1 hour video of WooCommerce, creating an e-commerce store for completely free. You can watch all those videos on this channel. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.